Rugby returns this weekend with the Singha Premiership Sevens at PT Sport, Cardiff Arms Park on Friday evening. Join us now to look ahead to the evening with Jonathan Spratt, Dafydd Howells and coach Richard Fussell. Dav was straight off the training ground in the first warm and dry day in about 3 months. Just right for you to get in the mood for a bit of Sevens non-stop action.
Yeah, it's been good. Boys looking quite sharp this morning, considering it's our first session together. So it's just one more now on Wednesday before going into the tournament Friday. So you should be looking good for the weekend.
You're one of the boys of the group with some sevens experience. So you're one of the ones that perhaps the youngsters are looking to.
Maybe a little bit of experience a few years ago. I think it's about 3 years ago now since I last played. So maybe not, but you know, I'll happily take that on board. Boys looking for a bit of advice if they really need it.
And it's a double-edged thing for you as well, because it's not just a bit of sevens experience, but personally it's the next stage in your recovery as well from injury last season, and targeting a good season with the Ospreys, so you'll be keen to make a good impression yourself.
Yeah, definitely. You know, since being out last November, I haven't managed to get back in the rugby field properly, so I'm looking forward just to getting back out, lacing my boots up again and getting stuck in for the first time in about 8 months, I think.
Game of non-stop sevens rugby on the artificial surface at the Arms Park. It's going to be a tough evening, particularly if the weather keeps on warming up.
Yeah, definitely. I think if the weather keeps warming up, it'll be a great spectacle for everyone coming to watch. And I urge as many people as I can to come down and support all the boys that are going to be playing there. Should be good.
Anybody in the group that Osprey supporters in the night should be looking out for?
I think all four teams are going to have quite a young side out, just because it's a proving ground for them, but I wouldn't underestimate any of them. I think every single player on that field is capable of doing something special at any point in time. And after seeing the boys this morning, I totally back us to come away with a really good result.
And a word for the old man, Jonathan Spratt, taking up sevens at the latter stages of his career.
All the best to him, I reckon. It's it's a tough old game, but he's been around long enough now to know the tricks of the trade and how to save himself some energy. So he'll be all right.
With under a month to go until Leicester Tigers come to the Liberty Stadium for a pre-season fixture, tickets for that match are on sale now from all the usual outlets. Alternatively, you can buy a 2016-17 season membership, with prices started at £149 for adults, that's less than £9 a game, giving you entry to European Rugby Challenge Cup, Pro 12 and Anglo-Welsh Cup fixtures throughout the season. For more details or to sign up for the new season, visit ospreysrugby.com/2016memberships. Plus, we're at the end of an early morning seven session ahead of Friday night's Premiership Sevens at BT Sport Cardiff Arms Park. How's it going? What's the mood in the camp?
Yeah, like you said, it's an early morning, so it was good to get the boys out here, get their mindset right, ready for the sevens training. And I think the boys bought into it really well. The kind of game we want to play, how we want to approach it, I think the boys bought into it. And throughout the training session, you could see that the boys really got stuck in. And we're adapted, and it was pretty early on in pre-season for these lads as well. So they adapted really well, and I thought they bought into what we wanted to achieve.
There's an interesting mix out there, some experience, some youth and some sevens expertise. How difficult is it bringing everyone together for something which is a different focus of what they might do every other week of the season?
I think we've got some key players, you know, like I said before, you've got some sevens boys in there, but there's some senior guys who can obviously up the communication between the youngsters and the sevens lads. So I think we had a really good mix in the squad, and hopefully that come game time that will show throughout the games.
We're a couple of years into the Premiership Sevens now, and it's your first involvement in it. What's your thoughts on it as a competition for development, for entertainment, for excitement, and just to give the players a chance to show what they can do?
I think sevens is going to start to really take off. It's going to be in the Olympics. I think it's going to be a really big thing coming in the near future. And I think for these youngsters, I think it's a great opportunity for them to express themselves, show what they can do. I know they get limited opportunities within our setup, but at the same time, when these opportunities do come around, I think it's great for them to grab it with both hands and show the Ospreys management and coaching staff what they've got.
And as a new member of the coaching group yourself, it's an opportunity for you to take control of a group of players in a competition, focusing on something and perhaps show what you can do.
Yeah, no, sevens is a new challenge for me, but it's something I've really looked forward to, and I am enjoying my coaching at the moment. And I think just being on the field and just being out here with the lads is just a great experience for me, and I'm really looking forward to Friday.
It's a challenge for you on Friday night. To the intensity and the pressure and the speed of a sevens competition game is going to be thick and fast. Are you looking forward to it?
Yeah, no, it's going to be new to me, but I think it's just going to be really exciting. I'm really looking forward to it.
John, then, a few days away from the Singha Premiership Sevens on Friday. You are the old head of the group, the experienced man in the squad. How are you looking forward to it?
Yeah, it should be really good, and everyone's really looking forward to it. There's a bit of a blend between youth and experience, as you said, with myself, but we've also got some of the up-and-coming Osprey boys playing. I know they're really looking forward to it. So it'll be nice to see how the boys go, actually.
Something different for you. Perhaps you've been around a while in the environment, plenty of games under your belt, but Sevens Challenge, perhaps something entirely different.
Yeah, it's completely different. I played a bit of Sevens in my younger days, so it's nice to actually get back to it. As I said, that's our first session there. It takes a bit of time to get used to. We've got a little bit more time on the ball. A lot more fitness is involved, but that's why it's great now for some of our younger boys to experience it. See what it'd be like playing in front of a good crowd, which we're hoping for on Friday, and to pull on the Osprey jersey maybe for the first time.
Talking to Fussell a little earlier, he suggested that your involvement as an experienced player is to be a communicator and be able to talk to some of the young boys through what could be a daunting experience for them.
That's right. Well, I don't know what else I'm offering, but I think I'm going to offer probably a little bit more communication what the younger boys are used to. That's a big part of Sevens. You haven't got 15 players on the pitch, so you have to, communications have to be dead on. So we try getting a little bit more of that this morning, but more importantly, it's more about the effort, and we're actually looking forward to hopefully some nice weather, touch wood, to throwing the ball around and playing some attacking style of rugby, which is what Sevens is all about.
And with the Olympics coming up in a couple of weeks' time and Sevens in that, do you see the focus on Sevens going a little bit sharper in months and years to come?
I do, definitely, as you've seen probably in the last 2 to 4 years, a lot more of the nations, the top tier nations are starting to take it seriously. You've probably always had about 4 top teams, but now you've got the likes of the USA taking it really seriously. You've always had Fiji, Samoa. There's also other teams driving through now. As you said, a lot of them looking forward towards Rio. So as Sevens goes, I think it's getting bigger and bigger as a sport. And that's only good for the 15-sided game. It's attracting more and more people, as I said, it's an entertaining and a fast sport, which Sevens is. So I think it's only good for the overall game of rugby as a whole.
And how long are you backing yourself to last?
I'm backing myself probably for the first minute, but I think it's rolling sub, so I'll be rolling on and off more often than not, I think.
That's all for now. Don't forget, tickets for the Singha Premiership Sevens are on sale now at ospreysrugby.com/buy-tickets. 2016-17 season members, you can claim your free ticket for the evening by calling in person at the Liberty Stadium ticket office. We hope to see you there on Friday night.